Hi, we're Hiatus Kaiyote and you're watching Dropout UK.
Dropout.
Sun, rise, a dark desert sky.
mean, it's exciting in the beginning, like my idols like my music, but it's a validation that is, I mean, we work hard at what we do and we put a lot of intention and a lot of love into what we're doing. And, you know, the reason that we admire these musicians is because they've been on the same journey in their own, you know, in their own flavors and essence.
And they've created things that, you know, we all aspire to. Create ourselves, which is just original ideas and stuff. A whole bunch of production stuff, I guess, and a whole.
Like a lot of the songs I'd written over this span of like probably from the age of 15. So for me, it was. Getting a band together and like hearing these songs that were really raw in their form, and then exploring the evolution, you know, with other artists and other people's you know, creative and emotional input. So a combination of like the evolution of my pretty early material in my songwriting, you know, lifespan, but also like from a production tip of like, you know, the guys coming up with stuff or like, you know, jamming and exploring sounds and not necessarily standard ways of recording either, because we didn't really have a lot to work with, so.
Yeah, it was a whole bunch of experimentation.
Yeah, the influences came from each other, you know, like it was the first time we met, we've been playing together, really excited about it, and the record is the result of that. So like the way it worked was just an exciting thing, exploring each other's, you know, creativity.
Yeah. I mean, when we started recording it, you know, we set out to make an EP, and I guess, you know, some people think of it as an EP, some think of it as an album, but we only really, we kind of set out to record some of the songs which were, you know, pre-written songs that they had sort of written, then we'd sort of brought our own thing to the arrangements, but then the way that we were kind of bouncing off each other, it just made sense to us to kind of try to weave it together into this one whole thing. So we did all these other studio experiments that turned into tracks, and it sort of, you know, it was just us kind of coming together and trying to create like one piece together, which is like the whole record,
which is a big thing for all of us.
Yeah. Dr.
Jekyll, that Mr. Bean bugging out my height again. If he coming rapping on my door, I'm not gonna answer it. I've been grieving, old fashioned at the seed, my seam is fraying. I've been grieving, old fashioned at the seed.
Yeah, it's like more just kind of absorbing your surroundings and your experiences and the people that you meet. So I mean, it's not a result specifically of traveling, but just the fact that I am alive and experiencing things, and then I document it.
Yes.
I mean, like, not specifically, but I mean, in the long run, probably.
Techniques.
Sometimes we do them like in underwater caves, and you have to trek like 38 hours to get to, but it's worth it.
It's not really like the record, I guess. We kind of do different style, like a different arrangement of tunes, and there's like some improvisation in there as well. And the band thing.
Yeah. It's all about really, I mean, so much of it just comes down to it sort of just us stimulating ourselves and each other, and hopefully that feeds into, you you know, the way everyone else experiences it as an audience, you know, we just like,
it's a bit of both, you know, like the audience would like give us inspiration. The audience is dry, you know, we don't tend to, you know, like improvise and stuff and kind of go outside the arrangements as much, but I think if the audience is really there, we have the confidence to like kind of go for things, and we know that like we can do it, we can fuck up, and it's okay, because like, they get what we're doing.
Yeah, they definitely different audiences definitely draw different things out of you.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
It's, you know, I mean, it's kind of comes back to sort of the same as the kind of music that we make. I mean, you know, trying not to put like a limit on that, really. I mean.
A lot of stuff from Mali, I love Takashi Yoshimatsu, George M. Muldrow, you know, classics like The Shining, J. Dilla.
I just ordered John Wizard's record, which I'm excited to check out.
Yeah, I've been getting into really early electronica, like, I mean, you know, like 1950s kind of experiments and that kind of thing. I really like this band from the UK called The Beatles, who were pretty cool. They're alright.
No, yeah.
They wrote really bad songs.
I mean, the combination of everything that we listen to is pretty. It's a pretty big list. And, you know, it's like every genre has amazing things to offer. There's always gold, like in every genre. You know, like. You know, even like country, most country I hate, but you know, like Hankley, you know, or something, I can totally get down with, you know.
I mean, if you're a music lover, you know, you've got the resources in this day and age to hear whatever you want at any point in time. So, if you are like fully immersed in music and you're passionate about it and you love it, you're not going to like close doors. You know? Yeah. You're always going to leave the doors open for checking out lots of different music. It's impossible to pinpoint any kind of genre that you're into, because you're into it all.
I think we're all pretty interested in like doing more collaborations with sort of instrumentalists and kind of getting more into sort of learning about different things rather than necessarily being like a name thing or anything, you know. I mean, you know, one person that I know we're gonna do something with is a friend of ours called Mick Stewart, who's an amazing multi-instrumentalist. Like he built this. He plays like a whole bunch of different instruments, but he built this thing called a polimba, which is like a whole like table full of colimbas, like the thumb pianos, and they've all got like a guitar pick up in them, and so he can play any sort of modality, like with kalimba, basically. It's totally virtuosic and ridiculous with it. So, you know, he's someone we're gonna, I'm sure, have on a track at some point.
Start recording a new record when we get back from December to Australia. There'll be a couple of shows here and there throughout the year, but the main kind of vibe is to get this record out.
Hi, we're Hiatus Kaiyote.
And please subscribe to Dropout UK.